Chair recognizes the gentleman from Georgia, Mr. Hice, for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to discuss a little bit the Wiener laptop discovery. You have explained there was a significant delay from the time that information was discovered, in which obviously hundreds of thousands, by your own words, hundreds of thousands of emails were discovered, potentially pertinent to the Hillary Clinton email investigation. There was a delay there, and you have explained in the past that the delay was caused simply because you were too busy. What were you doing during October of 2016 that caused you to be so busy?
Sir, I wouldn't call it a significant delay. I don't think it was caused because I was too busy. The answer to your question, in the fall of 2016, I was the Deputy Assistant Director of the Counterintelligence Division. I had responsibility over...
You've explained that you were
global,
you were too
sir,
busy.
Yes, but
what were you
I was
busy
trying
doing?
To explain what I was doing. I was busy overseeing thousands of cases, every espionage case in the FBI, every economic espionage case in the FBI, every case having to
were
do
you
with
involved?
The counter. Sir, you asked a question, may I answer?
Well, and I'm going to reclaim my time. Were you involved in the Russian investigation that time as well?
That was, aspects of that were one of the many things that were under my
supervision. So you were involved with it. Inspector General Horowitz expressed concern that so many individuals from the Clinton investigation mid-year team were assigned to the Russian investigation, people like you. Who made that decision for the people from the mid-year team to go to the Russian investigation?
Sir, I was Deputy Assistant Director of the Counterintelligence Division. I'm the number two. If there's something large going on in CI, chances are I'm going to have a role in it. So it isn't an
My
agent on
who
the
made
street
the
working the case, but the decision to assign me was certainly made absolutely by my boss,
okay.
The assistant
how many
director,
other
and probably
were,
above him, the EAD.
How many
and
other people went to the Russian case?
Sir, I can't get into those specific numbers. I can tell you of the senior managers, several of the senior managers were involved. But this is one of the points I disagree with the inspector general is he doesn't appreciate the staffing in the context of the level
anyone
of the people
in the
that
FBI
were involved
or
in
the DOJ
cases.
Question the overlap of personnel between the two cases?
Not that I'm aware of.
So no one questioned it. At the end of October, you were finally brought to the point to pursue the laptop information and to make it public days before the election. Did your involvement at that time with the Russian election interference cease when the Clinton email case was reopened?
No.
Okay. So you continued working on the Russian case while also leading the reopened Hillary Clinton case.
A colleague of mine, a co-lead, and I were bringing the team back together again.
Well, just
was
the
made
month
up,
before,
sir, if I may, because it's important. I think people have a misunderstanding. At that time, I'm a deputy assistant director.
All right.
When you talk
listen,
about the case, you
limited.
Have multiple. Yes, sir. You have multiple layers of people though below that are doing that.
I
work.
Understand that, but a month before, you told the IG that your Russia workload prevented you from addressing the issue on the laptop. Discovery, and
that's
now
not
all
what
of a sudden
said,
you
sir.
Have time for both, according
that's
to the
not
IG
what I said,
report.
Sir. That's not what I said, and that's not
that
what the report
there.
Says.
So days before the election, you're investigating two key investigations, and a time lapse of nearly a month goes by where there are hundreds of thousands of emails directly related to the email of Hillary Clinton and her campaign, ignored until days before the election, and only when the New York group demands. Well, let me ask you this. Were any of your superiors concerned of the overlap? That the time was, water was going under the bridge?
My recollection is that all of us were concerned about the volume of material that we had on
well,
our
Andrew
plate
McCabe
from a national
said that he was surprised
perspective.
That you had not reviewed the laptop before October 30th.
His
James
statement
Baker,
said that's inaccurate.
Counsel,
you're misrepresenting what's
time.
Said. You're misrepresenting
sir, this
what's
is in the
stated.
IG report.
You're misrepresenting what's stated in the IG
report. I'm using the IG report. McCabe said he was surprised that you had not reviewed the laptop information. James Baker, general counsel, said it was his understanding that that information was being handled. James Comey felt that the entire credibility of the Bureau rested on that case. And what gets me, how is it possible that you could handle both of these cases, perhaps two of the most important cases in the history of this country, at least in recent history? How, in the name of justice, does the FBI allow someone so biased as yourself to lead these two investigations at the same time? where both end up or being compromised, both tainted, justice apparently not happening in either case. You deliberately, from all appearance, delayed the checking into the Hillary Clinton emails on the Wiener laptop until after the election or as close thereof, and it's just corruption through and through. And Mr. Chairman, I yield back.
Mr. Chairman, may I